fertility diets, are they fact or fiction? In today's episode, we will discuss whether fruits, vegetables, fast food, seafood, trans fats, or carbs can help or hurt your fertility. Stay tuned to the end for my specific diet recommendations. First, don't get confused. There are many different types of diets for a variety of medical problems. A diet to lower cholesterol, for example, won't necessarily help with your fertility. Second, if you are overweight, any type of diet that will allow you to lose weight will improve your fertility. Let's get into some specifics. Fruits and vegetables. A new study found that women who eat fast food and little or no fruit take longer to become pregnant. For women who had the lowest intake of fruit, the risk of infertility increased from 8% to 12%. And in those who ate fast food four or more times a week, the risk of infertility doubled from 8 to 16%. Fast foods included burgers, pizza, fried chicken, and chips that were bought from takeaway or fast food outlets. These findings were true regardless of female weight. The Life or Longitudinal Investigation of Fertility and the Environment study of 501 couples planning pregnancy shows that couples consuming two or more servings of seafood every week enjoyed more sex and got pregnant faster than those eating seafood less often. After 1 year, 92% of couples with a seafood-rich diet had conceived, compared with 79% of couples with diets that contain less fish and shellfish. Another study found that women on a diet high in trans fats were 48% more likely to develop endometriosis than those with the lowest consumption. However, women eating a diet rich in omega-3 fatty acids found in oily fish seemed to protect against the disease, as these women had a 22% reduced risk of developing endometriosis. A survey of women with and without ovulation problems found that women with ovulation problems were more likely to eat low-fat dairy products, refined carbs, get their protein from animal products, and consume trans fats. So if you have an ovulation problem, avoid these things. A typical Mediterranean diet contains a high amount of vegetables, fruits, olive oil, beans, and cereal grains, moderate amounts of fish, dairy products, and wine, and only a small amount of red meat and poultry. A study from Greece of nearly 250 women found that those women who adhered most closely to this diet had 66% higher pregnancy rates during IVF. Men who follow the Alternative Healthy Eating Index, or AHEI, a diet rich in vegetables, fruits, whole grains, and low-fat dairy products, and a relatively low intake of refined grains, saturated fatty acids, and added sugars, showed significantly better results for sperm concentration, total sperm count, and percentage of normal sperm morphology compared with men who didn't follow such a diet. So, to put all this together, my recommendations for a fertility diet. It seems reasonable to eat some fruits and vegetables every day. Seafood at least twice a week. Stay away from fast foods and foods that are high in trans fats. If you have an ovulation problem, try to switch from low-fat dairy to high-fat dairy. Get more of your protein from plant sources than from animal sources. Swap out your current vegetable oil for extra virgin olive oil. The Mediterranean diet takes most of these recommendations into account already. If you follow that diet closely, you should maximize your fertility. If you like this video, remember to like this video. Do you have a question? Leave it in the comments below. Become a subscriber and get new episodes of Infertility TV weekly. Click the link in the description to visit our website where you can register to become a patient.